So let's have a look back at the laws of NP completeness. And the laws of NP completeness, of course, is a book that only holds unless P equals NP. If anybody ever proves P equals NP, then we can recycle this book here or delete the ebook. So what do the laws of NP completeness say? They say no polynomial time algorithm. So now it's time to think like lawyers and try to put loopholes into this statement here. And there's two loopholes that you can poke into this. One is that we only say no polynomial time. We do not say exponential time. What do I mean by that? Well, what about a running time like 2 to the power of the square root of n? It's not exponential time, it's called sub-exponential because you don't have the n as it is up here in the exponent. But it's also not polynomial time because you have some function of n up here in the exponent. A running time like this actually conforms with the law and it has an excellent speed up. So let's think about this for a minute. Let's say n equals 50. If n equals 50, what is the speed up of 2 to the power of the square root of n versus 2 to the power of n? Now, of course, we're going to do this as a quiz. Is it over a million? Is it over a billion? Or is it over a trillion? Of course, I only want you to select one answer here, the best possible one.